everyone, and welcome back to Nurses Lecture Room YouTube channel. My name is Mercy Mary, popularly known as the Nurse with the Difference, and I make learning easy and accessible for students. During the week, I got a request from one of my students asking me to create a video or to make a video on Glasgow Coma Scale. So today's video is going to be talking about Glasgow Coma Scale. But those that are writing their exams August and they have not started preparing or they are having difficulty, our revision classes have started on Telegram. So we encourage you to send a message to the WhatsApp number on your screen so you can join our students and we can joyfully celebrate you when the result is out. But before we go into today's class on Glasgow Coma Scale, kindly click on the subscribe button, turn on the notification button so you don't miss out. Let's go there. Right, welcome back. Like I earlier said, today we're going to be talking about Glasgow Coma Scale. What is Glasgow Coma Scale? Whenever you hear Glasgow Coma Scale, what should come to your mind is assessing the level of consciousness of your patient. Yeah, what? Assessing how conscious your patient is. Is your patient conscious? Is your patient unconscious? So whenever you hear Glasgow Coma Scale, just take note of the fact that you are assessing the level of consciousness of your patient. Glasgow Coma Scale is the most widely used scoring system. Like, it's the most widely used when it comes to assessing the level of consciousness. Under Glasgow Coma Scale, we have three headings, three different parts. The first is the eye response, which has four grades. The second is the verbal response, which has five grades. Then the last is the motor response, which has what? Six grades. But we are going to be starting from the first, which is the eye response. Looking at the eye response now, we're going to be using Mr. James as our example. For example, I am a nurse, as I am. Then I meet Mr. James. On getting there, Mr. James' eyes move spontaneously. Mr. James' eye is what? Moving spontaneously. Can you ignore the noise? Mr. James' eye is what? Moving spontaneously, like the way I'm moving my eyes. I'll give Mr. James 4. But if I get to Mr. James' side and Mr. James is not moving his or her eye spontaneously, but whenever I talk, I can feel it. Mr. James' eye is moving. I'll give him 3. And if I get there, he's not moving his eye spontaneously. I talk, he doesn't move his eyes. But if I apply pressure, I apply pain to his skin or his body, he moves his eye, I'll give him 2. But if I do all this, yet Mr. James is not responding, the eyes are not moving, I'll give him 1. So that is how to assess the eye response of what? Mr. James or your patient. Then the second one is the verbal response. Response to speech, response to talk. If I go and meet Mr. James and I ask Mr. James, how are you doing? Are you okay? He's soul oriented. He's oriented to time. He's oriented to space. He's oriented to persons and objects around him. He knows everything. I'll give him 5. But if I meet up with Mr. James and I'm like, Mr. James, how are you doing? He's answering the questions, but he's sounding a little bit confused. He's confused. I'll give him 4. Maybe I now want to go and meet Mr. James. He does inappropriate words. He's not making complete sentences. He's just saying words. There's no complete sentence. I'll give him 3, which is inappropriate words. Then if I meet Mr. James and Mr. James is mourning, you know, something is mourning, something like that. That's incomprehensible sound. You can't even comprehend what he's saying. He's not saying cop, he's not saying that, he's not saying go. So I'll give him 2. But if I meet Mr. James and Mr. James is not saying anything at all, he's just keeping mute, I would give him one. So that is that for the eye response, and this is this for the verbal response. Then that takes us to the motto response of Mr. James or your patient. That is movement. That's movement. So if I meet Mr. James and I tell Mr. James, raise your hand, Mr. James raises his hand, he's obeying command. Anything I tell him to do in regards to movement, he's doing it perfectly well. So I'm going to give Mr. James 6. If Mr. James localizes to pain, he moves to pain, wherever the pain is, he's moving down to that place, I'll give him 5. If he doesn't localize to pain, rather he withdraws from pain, I'm going to give him 4. Then if there's an abnormal flexion, he's flexing abnormally, you understand, flexion, I'm going to give him 3. Then if there is an abnormal extension, extending abnormally, I'm going to give Mr. James 2. And if there is no motor response at all, I'm going to give him 1. There is no 0 when it comes to assessment in Glasgow Coma Scale. The least you can get is 1. In terms of the sum, that the full calculation, the highest you can get is 15 and the lowest you can get is 3. 3 simply means death. All right, simply means death, or is like in a state of serious coma. We get. So in terms of the assessment, is it severe, is it moderate, or is it minor? So when you get less than 8 or 9, you say it is severe. Severe what? Severe unconsciousness. Then if it gets moderate is around 8 to 12, then minor, that's not as severe, the person is strong, you can get greater than 13 as highest figure. In our exams, they ask us, what is Glasgow Coma Scale? Explain Glasgow Coma Scale. How will you assess your patient's level of consciousness? So this, what I just explained, is what you are likely going to drop on that day. If you got value for this video, kindly click on the subscribe button, turn on the notification button, share, drop your comments in the comment section, drop your questions in the comment section. Thank you very much, and you have a wonderful day ahead.